हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द साइंस क्लास. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन विद द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज फन विथ मैग्नेट्स. यस, यू ऑल नो वेरी वेल अबाउट द मैग्नेट्स. यू हैव प्लेड ऑलरेडी विद द मैग्नेट्स, करेक्ट? यस, विच यू ऑल विल लाइक मोर. यस, अबाउट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन दिस वीडियो क्लास. फर्स्ट विल सी अबाउट द मैग्नेट्स. यस, यू मस्ट हैव सीन द मैग्नेट्स. They look like a small pieces of metal which have the power of attracting the object made up of iron. Yes, you all know very well the magnets will attract the iron materials. Yes, if you hold it for a wood, whether it will be attracted? No. Even for a plastic? No. Only for the iron materials it will attract. It has the power of attracting objects made of iron. A magnet is an iron object that makes A magnet is an iron object that makes a piece of iron or a steel move towards it. Nowadays we use a magnets for various purposes. We are using magnets for a various purpose. Where we are going to use that we will study. Some of common uses of magnets include iron pin holder, door closer in a refrigerators, magnetic stickers, magnetic pencil boxes. Yes, where we are going to use the magnets, you know very well, in your pencil box also, your compass, it is also sometimes to open and close, there will be having one magnet. Even in a refrigerator, yes, to open and close, it will be magnet. And even, yes, in your door also, yes, at the back side of a door, they will attach a magnet and one iron material. So that whenever the wind will blow very fast, the door should not go here. For that purpose, they will be attached with a magnet here, door closer, okay, iron pin holder also. Here are some uses of magnets. They are used in a iron pin holder, door closer in refrigerators, magnetic stickers, magnetic pencil boxes. In these all they are using a magnets here. Human beings have known about magnetic materials, the materials which get attracted by magnets. What are the about the magnetic materials? Nothing but the materials which get attracted by the magnets here. Since ancient times, the Greek philosopher Thales of Miletus, 6040 to 546 BCE, reported the earliest observation about the magnets in the 6th century BC. Greek used to call the magical stones which had the power of attracting iron objects. What these Greeks they called for magnets, they used to call it as a magical stones. Why they used to call it as a magical stones? Because they were attracted, they were having the power of attracting iron objects only as a lodestone. Later it was found that these stones are made up of a natural occurring iron called a magnetite. Then how it was found? These stones were made up of a naturally occurring iron ore. It is one of the magnetite is one of the iron ore. From that it was made up of. Do you know, they have given here, moving a bar magnet near circular metallic wire can produce a current in it. Remember this one. Okay. See here, lodestone had the power of attracting iron objects. This is the lodestone they have given. That lodestone was having what here? It was having a power of if the iron materials are there, they used to attract it automatically. Naturally occurring pieces of magnetite and iron ore. Magnetite is an iron ore. In this manner, it used to occur. Naturally occurring pieces of magnetite. It is one of the piece of magnetite. It is one. Magnetite is an iron ore. Remember. Here they have given the Greek story of a magnet. They have given here. There was a Greek shepherd named Magnes. One day he found that the nails in his shoes and the iron tip of his stick were attracted to a certain spot on the ground. To find the source of this mysterious attraction, He started digging the ground below the surface. He found some stones that attracted the iron. It is believed that natural magnets were discovered in this way. See how the he was going and he was having in his shoes he was having some iron nails and even to the stick he was having iron nails. Yes, as he was walking, some of the magnets were there on the ground. It was attracted. As if he was having the iron, it was attracting. So what he done? He started digging the earth here. So he found the magnets here, some of the pieces of a magnets, and those pieces were attracted to the what here? Iron particles. So magnet sticks attracted to a natural magnet on hillside. Here they have given here magnet stick. Here he is there. See, they have given magnet stick attracted to a natural magnet on a hillside. This was a story behind the magnet. Okay, the pieces of lodestone were called a magnets. What is a magnet then? The pieces of lodestone. Yes, as I have shown you the lodestone. Okay, that lodestone is stone is nothing but one type of a stone. It is lodestone is one type of a stone and it was having a power of attracting iron objects. What is a lodestone? Lodestone is one of the stone it is and it was having a power of attracting iron objects. So what they are, magnets means what? Magnets are nothing but the pieces of lodestone were called magnets. The small pieces of those lodestone only they started calling it as magnets. Because large deposits of a lodestone were found in an area in ancient Greece named Magnesia. Thus, small pieces of iron ore, magnetite, is called a magnet. The small pieces of iron ore name is here magnetite. The name of the iron ore is a magnetite. It is called as a magnet. However, it must be noted that naturally occurring magnets are now not available in the market. See, in a nowadays we are not getting a natural magnets. Okay, magnets which are easily available in the market are artificially made and well polished. Whatever we are getting in a markets, no dear students, those are not a natural magnets. They are a artificial magnets and they are all are polished one it is. Those all magnets are polished one and it is not a natural, it is a artificial magnets, whatever we are getting in a market. They are made in a different shapes for different users. Here you can observe the different shapes of a magnets. Yes, oval shape, a semicircle, cube, okay, cylinder, see circle. These all shapes we offer, different shapes of a magnets we are getting. They are made in a different shapes for a different users. Bar magnets, horseshoe magnets, round and cylinder magnets are the most common shapes of artificially magnets. Bar magnets, you know, bar magnets, horseshoe magnets, round, cylindrical magnets, these are the some of the artificial magnets. Again, we'll study here about the magnetic and non-magnetic materials. All materials that are attracted by a magnets are called magnetic materials. Market, this is very important, define magnetic materials. The materials which are attracted by a magnets. What are magnetic materials? These are the materials and which will attract the magnet here. The materials that are attracted by a magnet are called a magnetic material. For example, iron, nickel, cobalt and their alloys and substances made up of these materials are examples of magnetic materials. What are magnetic materials? Give example. The materials that are attracted by a magnet and are called a magnetic materials. Examples are iron, nickel, cobalt and their alloys. Nothing but these will attract a magnet. These are having a power to attract a magnet here. Also, magnetic materials can be magnetized, they can be made into a magnets. You can see in a picture how iron nails stick to a magnets. See how the iron nails are sticking. Iron nails are made up of iron. So it is a magnets. It is a horseshoe magnets we call. So these horseshoe magnets is attracted. Iron nails are attracted to this magnet here. Okay, the phenomenon of attraction of a substance by a magnet is called a magnetism. What is a magnetism? The phenomenon of a attraction of a substance by a magnet is called a magnetism. It is a force that is produced by some metals that pulls objects towards each other or pushes them away. So dear students, here you have to remember what is a magnetic material and give example, and what is a magnetism. Magnetism is the one of the phenomenon of the attraction of substance by a magnet is called a magnetism. Okay, then what are non-magnetic materials? You learnt about magnetic materials. Now we will study about the non-magnetic materials. Non-magnetic materials are the materials and which are not attracted by a magnet are called a non-magnetic materials. For example, paper. Paper is a non-magnetic material. Wood, concrete, brass, aluminium, plastic, glass, these all are non-magnetic materials. These will not attracted by a magnet. These materials will not attracted by a magnet here. Okay, these are some example of a non-magnetic materials. Dear students, till now we completed about magnetic and non-magnetic materials. In the next video class, again we'll move for the further part of the chapter. So till that, you study till here. Have a nice day. Thank you. Bye.